His saw hums like a musical instrument, playing a tune that always seems on the edge of melancholy. But for the hands creating the notes...
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
There is never...
Yeah.
...a downbeat.
That's my motto. Failure is not an option. So every morning you wake up, what did I do wrong yesterday that I don't want to do today? Keep the faith.
A faith that was severely tested...
Come down here in 2008. I was hoping to get a job with the furniture industry.
As soon as he arrived.
First night, I got robbed. All the money I had was gone that first night. Ever since then, it's been a struggle to get back on my feet.
So Don ended up out here, living on the street. He couldn't quite believe it happened to him. I mean, he had a skill, a drive to succeed. He didn't want to live off anyone else. But what Don really needed was a couple of well-informed friends. And he found them just a few blocks up there.
Greensboro IRC, how may I help you?
The Interactive Resource Center is something of a Grand Central station of services to help someone get back on their feet.
We're not turning anybody's lives around, but we're creating space for them to turn their lives around.
It's not a shelter, but it has all those things that someone either on the street or having a run of bad luck might not. A place to check or send an email, do a load of laundry, or have a prescription written.
The biggest issue we probably have is high blood pressure.
This place was exactly what Don Ames needed.
In Don's case, when things fell apart for him, he didn't have any deep pockets to draw on, so he had to draw on his own ingenuity.
Don took the woodworking skills that he developed in the boat manufacturing industry and turned the wood he found around his homeless encampment into art.
Praying hands.
The simple ones.
Puzzle clocks.
Or a collapsible bowl. He can turn out in a day. Others. Like the Westminster Abbey of clocks, take some, well, time.
Ooh.
A labor of love.
But I enjoy making people, how did you do that?
He did it while he still lived in a tent back in the woods near downtown. Don is a man who may be after his time.
Don's a 19th century man or an 18th century man. I could see Don and Daniel Boone crossing the Appalachians.
But he's here now and has to find his way like the 200 or so who come through the resource center every day and find someone who believes in them.
When someone walks through the door, we recognize they're coming here because they have a need, but we are much more interested in what strengths, what experience, what resilience, what do you bring with you? And that's a good place to start.
It worked for Don Ames, who got a place and is off the streets now and beginning to see his future.
I'm really not making a whole lot of money, but then I'm staying out of trouble. You have to keep your faith both in God and yourself.
And for those who can't quite do that right now...
You're welcome, honey.
The folks at the Interactive Resource Center will do it for them. Bob Buckley.
Okay, bye-bye.
Fox 8 News.